We're down here at Paul Kasmin Gallery. We're gonna sneak a peek in here. Looks like they're installing a Horace Lewis exhibition. This is James Kalm, the guy on the bike, coming to you from West 25th Street in the Cheim and Reed Gallery. We're going to take a look at Pat Steir exhibition, her recent paintings. This piece is called The Dark, and it's 134 by 215 and a quarter inches. And the essay that was written for the catalog was titled Gravity and Levity. And I think what a lot of this work is about is Pat's use of the drip and the fluid mixture of the paint. And also, if you look at the size and scale of these pieces, she's also paying homage to the abstract expressionists. And I think with this show, and as we go on to see some of the other paintings, you'll see that a lot of this is influenced by Barnett Newman. This baby is huge. This is a very impressive group of paintings here. This is White, 2007. And I think this piece is very obviously influenced by Barnett Newman and his Stations of the Cross paintings. But she's using a very different use of paint. It's almost coming at it from exactly the opposite direction that Newman would. This is all done with very watery, drippy paint. Many of these drops and drips and rivulets run from the top edge of the canvas all the way to the bottom. This is Black. It's also 127 inches tall. And you can also see that in some of these, she's got regular horizontal brush strokes. Based on part of the canvas. So she's playing with a lot of different applications of paint, layering and black over the white, white over the black. This actually looks like it's got a green underpainting on here. This is about the black. And she's also playing with the contrast between the matte surface, the dry surface, and the glossy and a shiny surface. You can see from the reflections that some of these do have a very, very shiny, wet look to them. It says in the press release that she was very much influenced by Chinese watercolors. This is another huge painting. Dusk. It's 134 by 215 inches. Some of this is so shiny it almost looks metallic. Oh, it is metallic. Silver. Does this give you the feeling of looking up a waterfall? And there's her zip. This does pay homage to the heroic romanticism of abstract expressionism. This is called Light, which also has a lot of silver pigment. Let's look in the back gallery. I've got some examples of more coloristic play. This is Sunspots, 2007. And here we've also got some gold metallic pigment. Huge washes. As a matter of fact, these washes are so overwhelming that they virtually wash away every sign of a brush stroke. It's nice, it almost has the quality of oxidized bronze or brass. Well, this is pink. Would be interesting to know how many layers of paint she drips over this, how much underpainting there is. You can see a bit of the pedimenti, but there's a lot of stuff hidden under these veils of dripping paint. So that's a report on Pat Steir, Gravity and Levity, her recent paintings here at Cheim and Reed. Thanks, Kate.